I don't think it is professionally correct for anyone to question scientifically prepared indices. So if the relevant authorities have calculated and worked out the equitable indices and income distribution trends, I would not challenge those. I would not question those. But having said that, I still believe there is a long way to go in this country. There are too many inequalities in this country for us to just keep a blind eye. The ongoing neoliberal economic policies apparently are favoring the rich than to the poor. And the government effort, government resources are diverted into giving facilities to rich or the high income classes at the expense of the low income classes in most of the cases. Taxation principle, subsidy principle is to create equitable society on top of earning revenue for the treasury. But this equitable principle has to be where you tax the people who can afford to pay the taxes and who are deserving the subsidies to be given the benefits. Unfortunately, there are situations where we do the reverse. One example is the expressway, I would call it expressway within bracket subsidy. Why I call it a subsidy or a criminal subsidy is because expressways are not recovering their maintenance, construction or loan payment costs by the tolls. Though there are tolls, the toll revenue is not enough to pay for those. That means what? The general treasury is shouldering the burden of construction of these. But unlike a general normal auto route or motor route, these roads are limited for usage by a certain segment of the vehicles. The three wheelers cannot go, the motor bicycle cannot go, the push cycle cannot go, the cart cannot go. I'm not saying that those vehicles should be permitted. That's going to be risky. But what I'm saying is, if those are not permitted, the user should pay for the true cost. At least let's apply the free market economic logic at least there and then make the user pay for the road. So let the true cost be charged on the user. Otherwise, it's very unfair by the poor man of this country, because the person who cannot put his push bicycle on the Adivegi Marga, the expressway, is shouldering the burden of maintaining this road. Likewise, there are many other subsidies in the society which the neoliberal economic policies and the economists are challenging, like the school uniforms, like the school books, or like the education expenditure, like fertilizer subsidy. Those are kind of, you know, question subsidies as to how productive those things are and whether those are skewing the economic balance in this country. But no one is questioning about the criminal highway subsidy, the criminal subsidy that the RDA is swallowing in. The people who are questioning about the deficits of the railway department are blind or deaf and dumb about the deficits or the expenditures of the RDA. That kind of a society we cannot call as an equitable society. So even if there is a trend, even if you believe that there is a trend of moving towards equitable society, we have long way to go. And when these kind of imbalances are there, I don't consider that kind of society as an equitable society.